hi guys, welcome to our third lecture in Calculus 3. Okay, so previously dun sa module 1 at sa module 2 natin, we've discussed several methods of establishing the convergence and divergence of certain series. So, ang isa pa lang nating alam na paraan para solve or ipakita whether nagko-converge yung isang series ay yung through the geometric series. So, diniscuss natin kung ano yung form ng geometric series, no, which is equal to a times r raised to n minus 1 or r raised to n. Depende kung ano yung, kung saan index tayo nag-start. And then, yung sum niya ay nakuha lang natin by the formula a all over 1 minus r. Okay, and then diniscuss din natin yung theorem 6, okay, wherein sinasabi niya na if a sequence a sub n is both bounded and monotonic, then the sequence converges. Okay, so nire-recall lang natin yung mga theorem na gagamitin natin later on, ano. Okay, so pag yung sequence daw ay bounded at monotonic, magko-converge yung sequence natin, but we don't know anything about the convergence of the series. Okay, no, note that magkaiba ulit yung series at saka sequence, ano, pakirecall na lang. Pag sinabi nating bounded yung isang sequence, either meron siyang upper or lower bound. Okay, so pag upper bound, lahat ng terms ay less than that. And then, kung lower bound, lahat ng terms ng sequence natin ay greater than that. Okay, and then pag sinabi naman nating monotonic, pwedeng dalawang case, no? Pwedeng kang maging non-decreasing or non-increasing. Okay, I think nasa name naman yung definition nun, ano. Okay, so now we will establish another way to determine the convergence or divergence of a series. Okay, so this time gagamit tayo ng isang lesson na natutunan natin from Calculus 2 and Calculus 1. Okay, which is the integral. So pwede pala natin gamitin yung integral para i-determine yung convergence ng isang series. Okay? Okay. So, ngayon, ang titignan muna natin na klase ng series ay yung mga series na lahat ng terms niya ay positive. Okay? Di ba kasi meron tayong mga series na alternating yung nag-iiba-iba ng sign dito. Ang titignan muna natin ay yung mga positive. Okay? So, how do we determine the convergence of a series? Titignan natin yung partial sums niya, no? And then we take the limit. Okay, kaya nga hinahanap natin yung formula ng nth partial sums. Pero yung na-discuss pa lang natin so far ay yung nth partial sum ng isang geometric series. Okay, so what about kung hindi siya geometric series, ano? So titignan natin yung limit noon, yung s sub 1, s sub 2, s sub 3, etc. And then s sub n, and then we will let n approach infinity. Okay, kung may limit yon, yun yung sum ng ating function. Okay, pero since hindi naman natin yung ibang partial sums, hindi naman natin pwedeng ipa-approach ng infinity, so nagiging approximation lang siya, hindi natin nakukuha yung exact sum. So i-discuss din natin later on kung paano ma estimate yung sum, okay, using the error. Okay. 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 So let's proceed with non-increasing partial sum. So bali meron lang tayong definition dito. So pag sinabi nating non-decreasing, each successive term is less than or equal to the previous one. So suppose that we have a sum, okay? So summation of a sub n, n equals 1 up to infinity, wherein all a sub n's are greater than or equal to 0. Pag sinabi natin greater than or equal to 0, non-negative siya, no? Okay, so positive lahat ng term, positive or 0 yung terms natin, okay? And then pag pinorm natin yung partial sum natin, we will have the following. So s sub n plus 1 is equal to s sub n plus a sub n. Okay, so we will have the following. Since nag-a-add lang tayo ng mga a sub n's, and then yung a sub n's naman natin ay non-negative, sure tayo na yung sequence ng partial sums natin ay increasing. So we have the following inequality. So s sub 1 is less than or equal to s sub 2, which is less than or equal to s sub 3, and so on hanggang kay s sub n plus 1. And then we continue until infinity. So if we let n here approach infinity, basically i-approach natin yung actual sum natin. Okay? Since the partial sums of the non-decreasing of then on decreasing sequence. Sorry, so since may yung partial sums natin ay nagpo-form ng isang non-decreasing na sequence, the monotonic sequence theorem gives the following result. So, i-recall lang natin yung monotonic sequence theorem. So, pag meron tayong sequence na bounded and then monotonic, yung series, yung sequence natin ay mag-converge. So, parang in-apply lang natin yung monotonic sequence theorem sa isang monotonic na series. Okay, so we have the following, a corollary to the theorem 6. So, if a series a sub n equals 1 to infinity of non-negative terms converges, okay, then its partial sums are bounded from above. And then, similarly, if its partial sums are bounded from above, then yung series natin ay nagko-converge. Okay, so yung pala yung definition ng if and only if, no? It works both ways. So, pwedeng ito yung ating, pwedeng ito yung if natin, if the series of non-negative terms converges, then its partial sums are bounded from above. And then similarly, since if and only if siya, pwede rin natin kunin yung kabaliktaran, if its partial sums are bounded from above, then a series of non-negative terms converges. Okay? So, yun yung meaning ng if and only if. Okay? So, sa corollary 6. Okay, so consider here an example. So we have the harmonic series. So series na summation ng 1 all over n when n equals 1 to infinity. Take note that kung kukunin natin yung limit ng sequence natin, mag-approach siya ng 0. Okay? Pero wala tayong alam tungkol dun sa series na yun. Okay? Hindi porket nag-approach ng 0 yung limit ng sequence natin ay mag-exist na yung sum ng terms ng sequence natin. Ano? Okay? Ang alam lang natin, ito mga usual ano to, misconception to. Hindi porket ang limit niya ay 0, mag-exist na yung sum. Pero alam natin na pag nag-exist yung sum, yung limit niya mag-approach ng 0. Okay? So it doesn't work the opposite way. Okay? So sabi nga dito, although 1 over n does approach 0, yung series natin ay nagda-diverge. Okay? Kasi wala tayong mahanap na upper sum for its partial sum. So, itry natin tignan kung ano itsura nung sum natin. So, we have here, so mag-i-start tayo kay 1 plus 1 half plus etc. Okay? So, kung i-consider natin to yung 1, okay? Maski nga alisin natin itong 1, magkakaroon tayo ng 1 half. 1 third plus 1 fourth is 1 half. Then, the sum of the next 4 terms is still it is greater than 4/8, which is equal to 1/2, and then the sum of the next 8 terms, okay, is still greater than 8 all over 16, which is equal to 1/2. Basically, we will have a sum, an infinite sum of terms that are greater than 1/2. Okay, so imagine niyo kung gaano karami yun, and taking the sum of those infinite 1/2s, wala tayong makukuha na upper bound ng partial sum natin. Okay, therefore, we can conclude that our series is divergent. Okay? Okay, so now, let's proceed to the integral test. Ano? Okay, so hindi muna natin siya gagamitin para i-determine yung divergence ng harmonic series. We will use it to determine the convergence or divergence of 1 over n squared. Okay, so consider the following example. Okay, so does the following series converge? So ito nga yung sinasabi natin. We have 1 plus 1 4 plus 1 9 plus 1 over 16, etc. hanggang kay 1 over n squared. Okay, so as the name suggests, malamang gagamit tayo ng integral. So ang gagawin natin dito, i-compare natin itong sum natin sa integral ng 1 over x squared dx. Okay, so natatandaan nyo pa kung paano ko na yung integral nito. No? Kung hindi na, pakirecall nyo na lang sa inyong calculus. Okay, madali lang naman to. Ito ay x raised to negative 2 and then gagamitan nyo lang siya ng power rule. Okay, so yeah. Okay, so continuein yun niya. I-compare natin. Okay. Kung hindi nyo na tatandaan, ang integral ay parang area under the curve. Ano? So, we can interpret the function values of, so yung mga terms natin sa sequence as areas ng rectangles na nasa ilalim ng curve na 1 over x squared. Kaya natin kino-consider yung integral. Okay, forming the partial sums, okay, so we get the following. 1 plus 1 squared plus 1 all over 2 squared, etc. Which is just equal to f of 1, f of 2 hanggang kay f of n. Okay, so kung ilalabas natin si f of 1, we get the following. F of 1 plus integral ng 1 all over 1 to n ng 1 over x squared dx. Okay, so integrating this one, we get the following. Okay, so since hanggang n lang to, alam natin, kasi n partial lang, partial sum lang siya eh. Since n to, and then we have here, parang in-approach na natin si infinity, okay, malamang magiging mas malaki yung area nito. Kasi non-negative naman yung graph natin, ano. So magdadagdag tayo ng positive, kaya siya naging less than. Okay, and then the integral of 1 over x squared dx from 1 to infinity is just equal to 1. So we have 1 plus 1 equal to 2. Therefore, yung series ng partial sums natin ay bounded ng 2. Okay, by our previous theorems, okay, the series converges. Okay, we can take a look at the graph. So ganito kasi yung itsura niya. Okay, so ito yung graph ng 1 over x squared, okay, yung blue line. And then, ito yung term by term. So, each rectangle represents a term in the series. Okay, so, ito yung 1 f of, ito yung 1 f of 1. Okay, so, yung, ang area lang naman nito ay 1. So, ito yung 1 over 2 squared. Yung second term natin, and then, etc. Okay, so, kaya siya naging less than dito, no? Dito, sa part na to. Okay, naging less than siya kasi mas malaki, merong mga areas tayo dito na hindi na-cover nung ating series. Kaya mas malaki pa rin talaga yung area na nasa ilalim ni 1 over x squared. Okay, so here is the formal definition of our integral test. So let A sub n be a sequence of positive terms. And suppose that A sub n is equal to f of n, where n is a continuous positive decreasing function. So note that continuous positive and then decreasing function siya for of x for all x greater than or equal to n. And then yung itong n na ito kailangan positive integer siya. If we have the following conditions, then the series sum of a sub n, n equals n up to infinity, and the integral of f of x dx from n to infinity, either both converge or both diverge. So gagamitin natin yung integral, ano. So kung ko-converge yung integral natin, malamang magko-converge din yung series natin. Kung nagda-diverge yung integral natin, magda-diverge din yung series natin. Okay? So that is the integral test. Okay? So, pwede nyo naman siyang i-prove, pero hindi naman kailangan. Pero, meron siyang proof sa internet, itong theorem na to, kung bakit siya totoo. Okay? Gagamitin na lang natin siya sa applications. Okay, consider the following example. So we have here the P series, ano. So natatandaan niyo pa yung P series, okay? Yeah, so we have here the sum of 1 all over n raised to p, n equals 1 to infinity. So we will show that if p is greater than 1, magko-converge yung series natin, and then if p is less than or equal to 1, magda-diverge yung ating series. Okay? Okay, so ang gagamitin natin ay si integral test. So, first case muna tayo, what if p is greater than 1? If p is greater than 1, then we have 1 over x raised to p to be a positive decreasing function. Okay, kasi lalaki ng lalaki yung denominator natin kasi si p eh, greater than 1. So, itong x raised to p, lalaki siya ng lalaki as x approaches infinity. So, since nag-approach siya ng infinity, magde-decrease tong f of x natin, meaning decreasing siya, no? Okay, so pwede natin gamitin yung integral test. So integrating, integral ng 1 all over x raised to p dx from 1 to infinity is just equal to x raised to negative p dx. Okay, so nireciprocate lang natin siya, and then nag-negative yung exponent natin. And then gagamitan lang natin siya ng power rule to determine the integral. So ang integral naman na x raised to negative pi, x raised to negative p plus 1 all over negative p plus 1. Okay, and then we take the limit as b approaches infinity. Okay, so evaluating from 1 to b, makukuha natin yung ganito. So ilabas muna natin si 1 all over 1 minus p. Okay, and then pinasok na natin si b at saka si 1. So in-evaluate na natin. Okay, i-recall nyo na lang, no, kung paano mag-evaluate ng improper integral. So ipapasok lang naman si b minus sa pagpinasok si 1. Okay? Okay. So we will have the following. So the limit of b raised to p minus 1 is just equal to 0. So meron tayong 0 dito. Times negative or minus 1. So magkakaroon lang tayo ng negative 1 dito, which leaves us with 1 all over p minus 1. Okay? Therefore, since nag-converge yung integral natin, alam natin na magko-converge din yung series natin or yung sum natin. Okay? Pero take note that yung sum natin ay hindi equal sa 1 all over p minus 1. Ginamit lang natin si 1 all over p minus 1 para i-determine yung convergence ng ating series. So alam natin na nagko-converge yung series natin, pero hindi pa rin natin alam kung ano yung sum niya. Okay? Yeah, so let's move on to the second case. What if p is negative or p is less than or equal to 0? Okay? The series will diverge. Bakit? Kasi if p is between 0 and 1, then 1 minus p will be greater than 0. So, what does that mean? Okay, so the integral of 1 all over x raised to p dx from 1 to infinity is just equal to the following. So, kaya na lang rin mag-compute ng integral, no? Pero power rule lang rin naman to. We will get the following. So, 1 all over 1 minus p times the limit of b raised to 1 minus p minus 1 as b approaches infinity. Okay, so since ito ay greater than 1, okay, or greater than 0, positive siya, no? This will continue to increase and approach infinity. So infinity minus 1 is just equal to infinity, ano? Okay, so since itong integral natin ay nagda-diverge by the integral test, yung series din natin ay magda-diverge whenever p is less than or equal to 0. So, na-cover na natin yung p greater than 1, p less than or equal to 0. Ang hindi na lang natin na-cover ay when p is equal to 1. Okay, so if p is equal to 1, we will have the following. So, ang tawag natin dito ay yung ating harmonic series. So, yung discuss na natin kanina, no? Okay, and na-discuss naman na natin kanina na itong harmonic series na to ay nag-diverge. Therefore, yung P series natin ay nagko-converge whenever P is greater than 1 and then nagda-diverge siya for any other value of P. Okay? Guys, pag nagpo-pause ako, or nag-i-stutter ako, meron kasing pag may nagsasalita kasi dito or may dumadaan na maingay, pinopos ko yung audio recording. So, please bear with me. Okay? Okay. Okay, so as we've said, yung P series natin, when P is equal to 1, ay tinatawag natin na harmonic series. So, the P, base sa PT, so pinangalanan na rin natin siya, no? P series test na siya, no? If P is greater than 1, mag-i-increase siya, but if p is less than or equal to 1, mag-diverge siya. Okay, so yun na nga, pag ginawa daw natin siya, pag in-approach natin, sumobra lang tayo ng unti kay 1, p is equal to 1.0001, okay, mag-co-converge na yung series natin. Ano? Maski unti lang yung idagdag natin. Okay? Okay, so yung slowness daw nung pag-approach ng partial sums natin sa infinity ay sobrang bagal. For example, ito, kailangan natin daw ng 178 million na terms ng harmonic series bago lumagpas yung partial sums natin ng 20. Ano. So, yun na nga, although nagde-decrease, alam natin na hindi bounded yung partial sums natin. Kaya sinabi pa rin natin na yung harmonic series ay divergent. Okay? Sobrang bagal kasi tignan nyo, 178 million terms na. Pero yung sum natin, hindi pa rin siya lumalagpas ng 20. Okay, so talagang kailangan nating ipa-approach ng infinity. Okay, so here we have another application of the integral test. So, ito ay hindi p-series, no? So, we have the sum of 1 all over n squared plus 1 from n equals 1 up to infinity. So, ang pwede natin gamitin para i-determine yung convergence nito ay yung integral test pa rin. So, forming the function f of x equal to 1 all over x squared plus 1. Okay, so ito ay series pa rin ng, or pag kinonsider natin siya, ito ay positive, continuous, and decreasing, ano, forever, whenever x is greater than or equal to 1. Therefore, pwede natin i-apply yung integral test. Okay? So, taking the integral of x squared plus 1 from 1 to infinity, we get the ito actually ay yung pag in-integrate natin ito, makukuha natin yung arctangent, okay? Or yung tangent inverse, okay? So, we have here the limit of the arctangent of x from 1 to b, and then we let b approach infinity, okay? So, it will look something like this. So, tangent inverse of b minus the tangent inverse of 1, which is equal to pi over 2 minus pi over 4, which is just equal to pi over 4. Now, since our integral converges to pi over 4, our series will also converge. Okay, so we have another example. So, determine the convergence or divergence of the series. So, again, ang gagamitin pa rin natin ay integral test. So, yung muna tayong first problem. So, we'll replace n by x muna, no? And then find its integral from 1 to infinity. So, we get the following. So, binaba lang natin yung, kinuha lang natin reciprocal para mawala yung negative sign dun sa exponent. So, we get x all over e raised to x squared dx from 1 to infinity. Okay? So, gagamit lang tayo ng substitution. So, if we let u be equal to x squared, we have du to be equal to 2x dx. Now, integrating, we have the integral of du all over eu times 1 half. So, nilabas na lang natin yung 1 half. And this is just equal to negative 1 half times e raised to negative u from 1 to b, and we let b approach infinity. Okay, so doing this, okay, so evaluate natin siya from 1 to b, we will get the following. And then this will just approach 0. Okay, so ang may iwan lang dito ay 1 all over 2e. Okay, so since nag-converge yung ating integral, malamang yung series natin ay magko-converge din. Okay, sa problem 2 naman, we have the sum of 1 all over 2 raised to ln n. Okay, again, we apply the integral test. So, we replace n by x and take its integral from 1 to infinity with respect to x. Okay? So, we let u be equal to ln x, and then ang derivative ni ln x ay what? Is 1 over x. Okay, pero hindi natin kailangan yun. If we let u be equal to ln x, we get x to be equal to x e raised to u. And then taking the derivative both sides, we will get dx is equal to e raised to u du. Okay, so substituting it back, we will get the following. So, we will get the following. So, the integral of e over 2 raised to u from 0 to infinity. So, evaluating the integral, we get so we have the limit of 1 all over ln e all over 2. So, ito ay constant na lang rin naman to, no? Pwede lang natin itong ilabas. Times e all over 2 raised to b minus 1. Okay, so taking the limit as b approaches infinity, note that si e ay, ang value niya ay 2.71. So, divided by 2, we'll have 1 point something. Or point something, and then erase that to something that approaches infinity, we will get a really big number, okay? So it will approach infinity. Okay, therefore, since nag-approach ng nagda-diverge yung ating integral, okay, nagda-diverge din yung ating series, okay? Okay. Okay, so far we have discussed that yung geometric series natin, pwede nating mahanap yung sum, di ba? Meron tayong formula. Pero hindi ganun sa lahat ng series natin. Ano? May times na hindi natin mahanap yung exact na sum. So, ang gagawin lang natin, papalapitin lang natin yung partial sums natin dun sa actual sum. Okay? Okay, so since hindi natin alam yung actual sum natin, magkakaroon tayo ng error. Ano? Pag sinabi nating error, yun yung parang kulang natin. Yun yung ia-add natin sa partial sum natin para ma-approach natin yung actual sum natin. Okay, yung S natin. Okay, so yun yung titignan natin. Ano? Okay. Okay, and then ang gagawin natin sa series na to ay ibabound natin yung error natin. Ano? Para makakagawa tayo ng isang estimate or approximation na kailangan natin para dun sa problem. Ano? So, depende sa problem kung up to what degree yung error na gusto natin, error dun sa ating partial sum. Okay, so, yeah, so suppose na meron tayong series na sum ng a sub n na lahat ng terms natin ay positive. Okay, so i-assume daw natin na nagko-converge siya gamit yung integral test. So ang gusto natin ay i-estimate yung size ng remainder ni r sub n. Okay, pag sinabi nating remainder, yun yung difference ng actual sum natin. So, ang actual sum natin dito ay denoted by S. And then, alam naman natin na si S sub n ay yung nth partial sum. Okay, so it is the difference between the total sum. Okay, so ito yung actual sum natin. And it's nth partial sum. So, we get the following. Note that ang S sub n natin ay hanggang kay A sub n lang. So, A sub 1 plus etc. hanggang kay A sub n. So, pag minus natin yun kay S, ang matitira ay a sub n plus 1 plus a sub n plus 2 plus a sub n plus 3, etc. Okay? Okay. Okay, so meron dapat ano to, no? Plus dot dot dot, etc. Okay, so para makahanap ng lower bound ng ating remainder, pwede nating i-compare yung sum nitong itong remainder na to. Pwede nating i-compare sa sum ng areas of the rectangle with area under the curve y equal to f of x. Napakita na natin itong image na to kanina. Okay? So here we have the remainder terms. Okay, so makikita natin dito sa first image na mas mataas yung values ng remainder terms natin kaysa dun sa area under the curve. So, ang kukunin natin na lower bound ay yung integral ng function natin n plus 1 to infinity. So, this will look something like this. So, ito yung magiging lower bound ng ating remainder. Okay, similarly, pwede rin tayo makahanap ng upper bound. Okay. How do we do this? Take note that itong remainder sums natin ay itong nasa left. Mas malaki yung values natin na nasa right or nasa left. Ito yung mga nauna. Kasi nga, decreasing yung function natin. Note that yung pagiging decreasing niya ay nanggaling sa definition nun, nanggaling sa requirements ng integral test. Pwede lang tayong gumamit ng integral test pag decreasing. So meaning, since decreasing siya, mas malaki yung area nitong from 0 to n na nasa ilalim ng curve kaysa dun sa area na covered ng ating remainder term. So, ang kukunin natin na upper bound ay yung integral ng f of x from n to infinity. Okay? Yan. Okay, so based on these results, we get the bounds for the remainder in the integral test. Okay, so parang sinummarize lang natin siya. Okay, if a sub k is a sequence of positive terms with a sub k equal to f of k where f is a continuous positive decreasing. So, yun nga, kailangan decreasing siya for all x greater than or equal to n. And that yung sum ng a sub n natin converges to s, we have the following. Yung remainder natin, r sub n equal to s minus s sub n satisfy the following inequalities. So, ito yung lower bound niya and then ito yung upper bound natin. Okay? If we add the partial sums S sub n to each side of the following, so we get ito, S sub n plus R sub n to be equal to S. So, si S yung ating total sum. Okay? And then, nakahanap rin tayo ng upper and then saka lower bound nung ating total sum or nung ating actual sum. Okay, so itong formula na to, we have this formula, pwede natin siyang gamitin sa pag-estimate, pag-estimate ng error. Okay, pag naghahanap tayo ng sum ng isang series, okay, na nagko-converge gamit yung integral test. Okay? Okay. Okay, so here we have an example. Estimate the sum of the series, sum ng 1 all over n squared using the inequalities 2 and n is equal to 10. Okay, so how do we do this? We first find the integral of 1 all over x squared dx from n to infinity. So ito yung hinahanap natin yung lower bound muna natin. Ano? Lower bound ng ating ito. Hindi. Itong remainder natin, okay? So, finding the lower bound of our remainder, we get the limit of negative 1 all over x to be evaluated from n to b as b approaches infinity, which is equal to the following. So, in-evaluate lang natin siya, we will have negative 1 all over b plus 1 over n as b approaches infinity. So, ito mag-zero lang, ang matitira tayo ay 1 over n. Okay, so, using this result with the inequalities in 2, we get the following. Okay? So, ito parang pinasok lang natin sa formula natin. So, ito yung integral natin, 1 over n plus 1. Okay? So, kung i-recall nyo yung formula to natin, we have s sub n plus integral ng n plus 1 up to infinity ng f of x dx. Kaya siya naging 1 all over 11 kasi magkakaroon tayo ng 1 all over n plus 1. So, since inassume natin na yung n natin ay equal to 10, don't worry, given naman lagi yan. Or pwedeng siya rin yung ipahanap. Okay? So, we get 1 all over n plus 1 which is equal to 1 all over 11. And we have here the s sub 10 which is the 10th partial sum. Okay? This is less than or equal to s yung actual sum natin. And s is less than or equal to s sub n plus the integral of f of x from n to infinity. Ito ay formula 2 lang natin to na sinulat ko lang rin ulit. So we have here ang integral lang 10 to infinity, integral ng f of x from 10 to infinity will just be given by 1 all over 10. And we have s sub 10 plus 1 over 10. Okay? Okay, now we find the values for S sub 10 or computin na natin yung 10th partial sum natin. Our 10th partial sum will be given by the following. So we have 1 all over 1/4 plus 1/9. So that is approximately 1.54977. Okay? And these last inequalities give. So kung kinompute natin to, so adan lang na, ipasok lang natin tong S10 na compute natin dito. Plus 1 over 11 and then S10 plus 1 all over 10. Okay? Ngayon, alam natin na yung actual sum natin ay nasa pagitan lang ng dalawang to. Nakita nyo ba yung ginawa natin? In-apply natin yung formula 2 para makahanap ng upper at saka lower bound ng ating actual na sum. Okay? Since hindi natin pwedeng makompute talaga yung actual na sum, yes, that happens. Pwede nating hanapin lang yung upper at saka lower bound gamit yung formula. And we get the following. Okay, so kung hahanapin natin yung S, I think a good approximation would be the midpoint. So pwede nating i-plus 2 at saka ito, makukuha natin yung, and then i-divide sa 2, makukuha natin yung midpoint. Therefore, the sum of 1 over n squared n equals 1 up to infinity is approximated to be 1.6452. Okay? So, we have here the error in this approximation is less than half the length of the interval. So our error will be less than 0.005. Okay? Pag gumamit daw tayo ng Fourier series, okay, so sa advanced calculus na to, ang actual formula or ang pinakamalapit na pwede nating ma-approach ay na value ni sum ng 1 all over n squared n equals 1 to infinity ay pi squared all over 6, which is approximately 1.64493. Okay? Okay, so ano bang application nito? Pwede kayong mag-estimate ng value nung series natin within a fraction of its exact value. Okay, so pwede nyo naman gawin yun sa, makikita nyo yun sa mga exercises natin. Ano? For example, estimate the sum of blah 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 within 0.01 of its exact value. Okay, again, kung meron kayong questions, pwede lang kayong mag-chat sa akin. Ano? And then I will send your modules later. Okay, pasensya na pala kung medyo paputol-putol kasi talagang na-stress ako. Pinopost ko talaga yung video kasi merong mga nag-grass cutter, merong may dala ng wheelbarrow dumadaan sa harap namin, may nagmamartilyo. Kaya pinopost ko yung recording. Okay, so kung wala nang tanong, chat nyo na lang ako. And see you on the next one. Reminder lang, next week will be our prelim exam. Okay, good luck.